Welcome back to the Sanctuous Martyr Players 8 playthrough. I'm going to be starting Hell Difficulty. Unfortunately, the Nightmare Cows that I did also did some Nightmare Terror Zoning. That recording unfortunately had some corruption, so oh well. Bringing up to speed a little bit, I upgraded the Bone Snap. Just waiting on getting a little bit more strength to equip it. It's been I think a pretty cool swap throughout this playthrough, so I'm going to be sticking with that, although some other options for putting on swap is having the heart carver on swap. It's really nice for the ignores targets defense and a little bit better chance for deadly strike than our honor, and more damage, so that's definitely an option if we get into a situation where it's getting hard to hit monsters. Maybe I swap back to Heart Carver for a little bit. Also, we found, I don't know if this happened in the Terror Zone, Nightmare Terror Zone or not. Maybe so. We got the gauntlets. I'm going to say that happened that. I just can't remember. I don't think I had the three-piece set Saigons. And I think I'm actually going to rock that at the start of Hell. So I'm losing a little bit of life that I'm getting from Talrosh's helmet. Also some mana leech. This build doesn't use mana a ton, but certainly I've been, you know, using it a lot to keep Holy Shield up and charge away from things or charge to things. So that's been using up my mana pretty frequently. These boots have been great, but we actually get better magic find with the three-piece Saigons, so that's pretty cool. Unfortunate that we're losing some crushing blow off these gloves, but we're gaining a lot of increased attack speed, so I'm liking that. And of course, I didn't mention that the helm swap giving us our big attack rating boost. That's going to help us hit enemies. So, got several runes here. Got an IO rune, looking for more shale runes and something else we can put in our three socket helm. For something, I'm thinking, is it hearth? I'm going to say it's the hearth rune word that gives us cannot be frozen on the helm. So that could be an option that would open up our shield slot to, you know, use this shield with a bunch of diamonds in it for big resistances. Although we do lose a lot of block chance on that. So I'm thinking maybe going for Moser's, using Moser's here. It's got better attack, or it's got the good chance to block, and can throw two diamonds into that, so that could be an option if we want to beef up our resistances even more. Also, this belt, I almost want to swap on starting hill just for better resistances that it has on it, but the chance to open wounds, I think, is really going to help counter the monster's regenerative life, or life regen, that we're going to face in Hell. So I'm going to try to keep this open wound source, and maybe that means we need to craft another belt, see if we can get better open wounds on that, and maybe even better stats than we already have on a crafted belt. Let's see, so we talked about the upgraded Bone Snap. Pretty cool. Oh, and we can almost wear Bone Snap when we have the Saigon swap, so that's kind of nice. 123 strength, and it needs 124, so we're really close there. Also have Goblin Toes to swap on for a better chance of crushing blow. And these boots are just nice boots. I believe this, I just did this in Bew after the Nightmare Cows and Nightmare Tear Zones. Went back to normal, imbued these Wormhide boots with Charcy, and it came up pretty good. You know, compared to our regular boots, they don't have the magic find. They have, I would call, a little better resistances, that fire being a nice addition, and of course, better, faster run walk. Helps us move around faster, so. Interesting boots. But we'll go ahead with Zygons. All right. With that, trying to think of what else has kind of changed. I found a big mana Grand Charm. Not really interested in that in this build, but that was pretty cool to find that. Scaled down my magic finding gear. I used to have boots with slightly better magic find and gloves with slightly better magic find, but it was just altogether, I think it was like 8 more magic find between the two of them. And I'd just like to have a little simpler swap, just swapping the armor and helm and rings, amulet, and then putting on these charms just for a little bit. Looks like my screen went black there for a bit. Not sure what's going on there. I may stop the recording and just see, double check that it's actually doing it what it needs to. And we'll continue on with the showcase after that. Okay. Looks like everything is okay. So looking at our showcase, found this really cool helm. I believe this was a Nightmare Terror Zoning. Too bad we're not a melee druid, because that'd be pretty cool. Also found a Razor Tail. Getting rid of the Spirit Shield and Wall of the Eyeless, because we have moved on to... Actually, I guess this is a good time to do the character and mercenary showcase, see where we're at here. So, stopped using the Act 3 Mercenary when started out cows, actually. I was noticing that just the area of effect, the amount of cows he was able to freeze at any given time just didn't seem quite as much as the Freezing Arrow Rogue could do. So, right now, just put a bunch of just resistance and max damage charmed. Or jewel, excuse me, that I had picked up throughout the playthrough. I guess one of them also had some magic find, looks like there. Just put that in a 3-socket stag bow for now. We'll probably take out these jewels once we have the runes for, say, a edge bow to get increased attack speed on this bow for her. The biggest thing I want her to do is not so much damage, but just crowd control. So I want her to shoot this freezing arrow as much as she can, as frequently as she can, which is great. And it sure seems like her cold damage is already better, like the Act 3 Merc, even with the plus skills from Spirit. I think he was doing like 350 cold damage, something like that. So she's already doing better damage with her freezing arrow than the Act 3 Merc was doing with his ice blast. So I gave her a smoke to help her resistances, so she's looking really good here. Already capped out, so hopefully that keeps her alive, as well as the cure, giving cleansing aura. It's going to be helpful, I think. Skill wise, we are capped out on sacrifice and its synergies of fanaticism and Redemption. So looking good there. Just been pumping up Holy Shield and got 1 point away from Vengeance. Vengeance being our kind of our go-to in cases where we encounter physically immune animals. That's going to be coming up in Act 2 Hell, specifically getting through Far Oasis and Maggot Lair is my main concern there. Because we have yet to find a source of Amplify Damage or Decrepify, either as charges or as procs on a weapon. So, yeah, looks like you're going to have to dip into the elemental damage of Vengeance a little bit there every once in a while. That's how we're going to handle those situations. With that, yeah, I guess other things I wanted to mention was set aside some runes here. This is these are the runes for Passion. We just need a Lem. And also the runes for Oath. So Oath, I think, is going to be really, really sweet if we can get it, but it's going to need these two runes, or these two spaces will need to be filled with Mal and Pole. Don't remember if that's necessarily in that order, but we need to find Mal and Pole to make Oath a possibility. We need to find Lem to make Passion a possibility, and then that will make this Knout into what I think is going to be our best weapon to that point. When we get a Lem, we can also get Treachery. So obviously, would love to find before we find the Lem, a Mal and a Pole. because if we find a Mal and a Pole, that'll mean we already have our Oath, and we can put that Lem towards building a Treachery. Of course, we need to get a 3-socket armor also for Treachery. That's kind of holding us back from Treachery as well as the rune. Is ideally would like to move away from Peace into a Treachery and maybe even a Duress. But that said, this Peace, the crowd control we get from the Valkyrie, she's been holding up pretty well at level 15. She's not the strongest, obviously, and she's going to be falling off more and more and more as we get through Hell. But it is nice to have that additional distraction to keep monsters off us a little bit. Let's see. We have this Ancient's Pledge. I think that's finally time to just retire these two we were using for our Act 3 Mercenary. So we can clean that out. And trying to think if I've missed talking about anything. I also wanted to highlight this. I can't remember when exactly, if I found this since the last recording or not, but in fact, I think this dropped in Cows, Nightmare Cows. It's unfortunate it didn't drop as an exceptional base, because this would have been a really, really cool weapon. That scaling max damage, the increased attack speed, even if it was more than 20, that'd be really great attack rating. Like, this is the type of rare weapon I think that's really, really nice. Would be nice, very appreciated to have in our build. In fact, heck, we have room. Let's just keep that around, just because he's so cool. I was holding on to this helm for the resistances, but the attack rating, but that attack rating can't compete with the attack rating we're getting from Saigon's, and those all resistances just aren't as good as Talrosh's helm, so we've moved away from that. Mosers are lesser Mosers. Putting this over here. Also kept this shield in the showroom just because it's a rare that it tried really hard. It's got good resistances, good all-res resistances at the time, and as well as the poison length reduced. So, yeah, that's pretty cool. It's still unfortunate it wasn't quite as good. You know, by the time we found this, I think this was like late nightmare. And by then, I mean, we had our Rhyme Shield that has nearly as good resistances as these, and it gives us that cannot be frozen, which we just cannot do without. So, okay, with that, let's clear some of these guys out. Refresh our showroom a bit.
Good to see you.
Impossible.
Also found Razor Tail at one point, which again would have been, that would have been sweet on our Boazon playthrough. Never did find it though. Just realizing we could use the spirit sword on our swap. For pre-buffing Holy Shield. Yeah, let's do that for now. Personally get a little bored of pre-buffing, so can't say that I'll keep it up. You know, Cathans, I'm actually going to keep Cathans around. It's an interesting swap because it gives us the plus strength if we need it in a pinch. You know, we get, maybe we drop a really cool weapon that we're just short on strength for, and that's going to enable us to equip that weapon quicker. And it's got a bit of attack rating bonus. So I think I like that idea. Let's keep these guys around, just like we're also keeping Angelics around. And you know what? At this point, I'm never going to use Angelics sword or death sword, so we'll just keep the jewelry of those sets around. These are the rings we're just re-rolling. Gonna keep the steel because it's our personalized one. And maybe it's time to finally say goodbye to our first ethereal big damage weapon. Oh well, they don't take too much room up. But you know what? We'll keep Noka's in around too. If we need big fire res at some point, we'll put him here. Okay. So, okay, not too worried about these guys just taking up a little bit of space there. We'll keep them in our hearts. Let's see. Also, keeping Tancred's and Vidala's set pieces around, because those could be potentially good magic find swaps for us. If we find, I believe it's the Tancred amulet and the Vidala's amulet. Can't remember which bonus is better on them. So, just keeping both of them around for now. Without further ado, let's start in on Hell Act 1, Players 8. Let's verify we are indeed still there on players 8. We are perfect. Zombies are going to be a problem, but that increased attack speed is very, very nice.
Welcome.
Not in time.
Really do hurt. This build is not recommended for playing hardcore. Wow, this build and my playstyle of yellowing in is not recommended for hardcore. Like four very, very nasty elite groups right off the bat. Cursed lightning enchant conviction. Youchie. Hey, maybe this is our three open socket. Oh, it is three open socket, but it is ethereal. Unlucky.
Hello.
so we know what we can do. Take off our piece and swap it for our Merc Smoke. That gives us better resistances, and we can keep this Valkyrie one that has Amplify Damage. That's pretty cool. Because we do technically have a source of Amplify Damage. Zombies are up here. Gonna have plenty of time that needs to be taken to kill the zombies in the Den of Evil, so I'm jumping in. Yeah, at this point, I think I'm just gonna put these ethereals in the showroom because, I think I said in the past, maybe that was in the recording, Late Nightmare, that I got corrupted, but ethereal, I'm not looking to make ethereal rune words for our mercenary unless we get some excess runes. So if I'm able to make, if I've already made a treachery or a duress, and I have extra runes for another treachery or duress, and I want to put that on the merc grate, I'll use ethereal. Otherwise, I really like the option of having rune words that I can swap between myself and my merc. I mean, the case in point, just like this, we can give her peace now to give her better skill damage. Yeah, she's now doing 600, which is great, instead of before she was doing basically average 500.
I'll put that to good use.
And now we don't have to worry about reprocking and recasting the Valkyrie, because we have a Valkyrie that's working well for us with amp damage procking, which is great. Forgot that I had redone that town portal. That's fine. That amp damage procs is so nice. Also, I'm kind of thinking if we're going to have some slow kill speed like this with the zombies, that's 48. Yeah. Upgrade our attack rating a little bit. Yeah, to 93 instead of 93 chance instead of the 91 that we were before, so I like to see that.
Not in town.
So, dealing with some slow kill speed, so not going to be picking up, dropping a bunch, so not going to be picking up a bunch. So just don't need that extra inventory space. Other thing I'm replacing. Instead of spirit and that guy, let's see, we are just three away. Not one of these attack rating, yeah, this guy. Should have equipped that anyway. Now we have enough strength for bone snap. You can get some crushing blow into it. Work on those zombies a little better. 3,300 damage. Love to see it.
Not in town.
Oh, excuse me. 4,400 damage. There we go. That's going to be nice to take down those zombies. That's not ideal. That's gonna be spicy. Alright, we'll deal with him at the end. Respawned over there.
Welcome,
don't really want to lose her. She's got our amp damage proc, I believe, still.
I am overburdened.
Can't remember if Corpse Morn, I think that's his name. So he's conviction. I sure hope he's not lightning enchanted either. That would mean it's gonna be nearly impossible to kill him. Paige, what are you doing? Got amp damage. Yes. They're clocking it better than our Valkyrie is.
Yes.
Well, I was saying three remaining. We just killed two. I'm a little confused. Weird, there's text showing up every once in a while. My mouse over something. Maybe there's a dead rogue under, like, right behind these rocks. Yeah, oh well.
I can't carry anymore.
Getting in the way. I was trying to charge him away. Too bad.
My duty here is done.
Good evening. You have cleansed.
All right, we're going to use this skill point on vengeance so we have a guaranteed way to hit stuff. That's immune to physical.
Good evening.
nice and tidy.
Not here.
Hello.
Just out of curiosity, let's see what kind of vengeance damage we're doing. 900, okay. As opposed to sacrifice, 1500, so, okay. Something.
Not in town.
It's enough to whittle things down.
Thank you.
Page is not just standing back shooting them.
My rope.
It's very frustrating. Not that we were doing that great anyway, but
greetings.
That's just one more thing. It's a little annoying when she wants to go in there and just get right in the mix of stuff.
Good day.
Not here.
I do not know what is possessing her to keep just walking in there.
Good day.
All through cows. There was a couple times where she would just come into the midst of the cows when I was doing nightmare cows, but it was fairly rare. But here she just keeps running right into the mix and aggroing things.
Yeah.
just suck at aiming. Charge, apparently. Just does not want to attack her.
Thank you.
Overburdened.
Nice! Got an extra showroom. Love to see it. Alright, that's cool. That might be worth, gosh, with our extra showroom. Almost want to sock it bone snap. Socket this guy. Make him that much faster. I mean, he's got skilled magic, max damage, but not skilled min, so it's gonna fall off more and more, though. Or we have, okay, we have the shale IO. We can use one of our three socket helms. We can make a hearth. We find a co, we could think about doing a hustle. Now that is interesting for us. +6 to evade, +10. We've never actually made a hustle, so. Maybe we want to save that up for, save that shale up just in case we get a co. Co's not super unlikely. Actually, even the hustle weapon isn't terrible. I'd have to find a really good base for it, though. Where I was going was the hearth, which, again, man, this mod doesn't show the cannot be frozen, but I'm pretty sure it has cannot be frozen. So that would be a thole. We do have the runes for this. Shell Io Thole. That means we lose our helm. We still have the increased attack speed, a little bit attack rating. We lose the magic fine. We dropped a 77% chance to hit versus 84. I really want to stay up in the 80s plus and chance to hit. It's also something we could put on our mercenary so she doesn't get frozen. Thing is, I mean, we got everything going for us except just the damage is just not great right now. We need a better weapon. We need a weapon that has a top end of 200, ideally. At least. And we'd be hitting pretty hard. The reason I say 200 top end, because when our Valkyrie was pet, but proccing amp damage, when things were amp damaged, we were actually, I mean, we were moving through stuff pretty solidly. So. I mean, the other thing, since we're getting some magic fine, we just got a little bit of attack rating here. What we could do is get our crushing blow back in the mix, because we've lost crushing blow since we don't have these gloves. We don't have the magic find anymore. Do we have anything yet? Okay, still have 32 from something. Is it just ring? Oh, it's mostly our rhyme shield, that's right. And then 7 magic find from something, maybe the ring, yeah. Ring. Okay. So we get crushing blow back into the mix. That'll hit it. Let us hit hard.
Not in town.
A little more. But now we can't equip Bone Snap anymore. We need. Oh. There we go. Okay. Yeah, so we're still getting the plus 10 strength from the gloves. Okay. Let's rock this setup. We're a little slower walking, but I think getting the crushing blow back into our repertoire, that's going to be clutch.
Thank you.
carry anymore.
More skill here.
Overburdened.
Immune animal. Yep. Alright, let's see if we can lure him away. We'll try our vengeance. Thank you. sure if we're going to be able to deal with physical immune animals. With high life, that is. I was worried more about the swarms. Which, I mean, this guy we can just... we can bypass, but... and the swarms are going to be way less life than he is, but just wanted to give proof of concept here, but it's looking pretty... not, it could be worse, but he's definitely very tanky. Great, we have a source of amp damage even, and it's not helping much. Of course, I need to be switching to my sacrifice when he amp damages. Or when he is amp damaged. I wasn't doing that, unfortunately. It is possible. Pretty painful, though. Just hope we don't run into much of those guys. From here on out, I'm probably just going to bypass them, just avoid them all altogether.
Thank you.
This holy place has been desecrated.
I was doing all that with vengeance. Ugh. Alright. Need to keep my main skill on there. Let's pick a... Let's pick a hotkey for vengeance. Page, just doing page things currently. Just stand back and shoot. That's all I ask, Page. I guess that's too hard. Join my army. I need more mana. Keep charging like that.
Good day.
It's not a terrible ring with Aura 7. That is quite interesting. And that is almost better than that ring on the right. I kind of like the +5 strength that ring on the right has, but... resistances are hurting. That is an interesting ring. I'll keep that around.
Not here.
Darn. It's just going to take way too long to chop through all that. Just wasn't getting the charge hits that I needed to. Thank you.
Greetings.
Fine.
Sisters, there is no other way.
I can hurt.
Good day. It is clear.
Not here.
No, thank you. Packs everywhere.
Yes.
Greetings.
Not in town.
Oof, sure not feeling hell viable right now. It is a uphill battle. Maneuver, that's why. Trying to use sacrifice and doesn't seem to be. Sanctuary. I was using cleansing. That's why. Sanctuary definitely is helping, but not quite enough.
Hello.
And maybe at this point, maybe I start using my points, you know, become that much more of a Sanctuous Martyr and get more Sanctuary going. I think maybe that's the way. That'll let me deal with the undead a lot nicer. Yeah. So I think I have plenty of points in Holy Shield at this point. Got my Vengeance. That did its job for whittling down a physical immune animal. A really tanky one, by the way. Gargantuan Beast, so. Yeah. Upgrading Sanctuary. That's the next play. Yeah. Don't really want to fight a mighty dragon issue. Let's find that waypoint first.
I am overburdened. I am overburdened. I can't carry anymore. I can't carry anymore.
There we go. Nice. We got an XP shrine right next to the waypoint. Okay.
And so it came.
We see an elite pack that's not regular. Two XP shrines. All right. If only there was a isolated elite pack. There it is. Nice. Get some XP from them. Oh gosh, maybe not. Ouchie. Cursed archers, huh? That's not what the doctor ordered.
What can I do for you?
The Order welcomes you.
Yeah, they're cursed, so they're just going to take our XP shrine right away from us as soon as they curse us. Grab the XP shrine, go back into our town portal, and just see what we can do against Rakanishu. Maybe peel some stuff off, get him away from that Midora.
overburdened.
I'm gonna like the misshapen. Our lightning res isn't great, but I like how weak they are. Before I should have checked him earlier. I was about to town portal back and get another XP shrine, but if they're cursed, it's not gonna be worth it.
Overburdened.
Greetings.
Not in town.
Oh, I think that's an improvement. Oh, yeah. Well, I'm very tempted to use the shale.
Your presence honors me.
I'm gonna shale on this for better resistances. And if I recall, the rhyme shield is it plus 25? Plus 25. Very nice. So that'll give us 60 all res instead of plus 37 all res. Yep, that's what it's gonna be. Alright, sure hope I find more shales. Oh, I'm an idiot. Oh my goodness. I could have sworn it was a two socket. Wow. Well, darn. All right. Things are not going our way in hell so far. Oh, what a waste. Thing to put in that was an ancient pledge, which would have been even more insane resistances, but I just was so excited for an upgrade, but wasn't thinking. Well, darn. Alright, well, we'll put it in the showroom for showcasing. Stupidity. Darn.
Not here.
Yeah. risky, but I just had to get rid of those shamans. Sure felt like our block chance was not working there.
Greetings.
What you need?
Not here. Not here. I can't carry anymore.
Is he running away? All I see is bleed animation. Maybe they fixed that in D2R. I don't remember seeing a bleed animation like that. The old graphics, you definitely see blood all over the ground. Maybe the bleed animation has always been there in D2R, just not the blood puddles. I take it back. Those misshapen, they are relatively weak compared to the other guys, but man, do they hit hard with that lightning. Yep. Ouch. Click on stuff, I guess. Alright, might be time to just take a break. I don't have enough self-esteem to keep going. It's too much stuff working against us. Mentality in the game. Time to take a break after this recovery.
Can't carry anymore.
As soon as it was lightning enchant. Oof. Alright.
I can't carry anymore.
That's a little depressing. Maybe I've bitten off a little too much with this build. It's starting to wear on me. Hopefully see you guys after the break. Thank you for watching.